Great experiences on Android TV are casual, cinematic, and simple. You can lean back on the couch and enjoy hundreds of movies, TV series, and videos from various sources. But wait, how can you find your favorite movie amongst thousands of movies in your library? Well, the answer is that you can just search for it. In fact, searching is something that Android TV does really well. I'm Wayne Piekarski, a developer advocate at Google, and today I'm going to show you how search works on Android TV and how you can surface the great content of your app to your users. This here is the Android TV home screen. Users can easily access the search menu and ask for anything using their own voice or via keyboard input. The results are displayed in a well-organized form, and users have one-click access to launch the content. So this is a really cool feature. So you might be worried that your users won't be able to find the content contained within your app. The good news is that Android TV Search enables your app to surface its content outside of the app. Your users will be much happier to easily find what they're after, and in turn, this will drive engagement with your app. Let's quickly look at how search works. Android TV will show the search results from Google, but it also queries locally installed searchable apps and combines these results. Building a searchable app on Android TV is just the same as building a searchable app on other Android phones and tablets. So you can use exactly the same Android tools as what you're already familiar with. Let's talk about what some of the steps are to go and make this happen. First, you have to let Android Framework know that your app is searchable. This is done by adding an XML file with some metadata in an XML resources folder, like this one here. So what does this file look like exactly? Label is the name of your app, and it should be the same as the name applied to the Android label attribute of your activity or application manifest element. This label is used to identify your application when providing search results and to categorize it. The search suggest authority uniquely identifies your content provider. Therefore, this value must match the authority string provided in the Android authorities attribute of the Android manifest provider element. And search suggest intent action is the default intent action to be used when a user clicks on a search result. Mainly, this is a view intent that what we use here. This is a deep link into your app and should go straight to the selected content. Finally, since we want to surface our results globally, we need to set the include in global search attribute value to true. For more detailed information of other attributes, you can always refer to this link in the Android developer documentation. Next, you need to define a content provider for the search results in the Android manifest XML file. As I mentioned earlier, the content provider should have the exact same authority string provided in search suggest authority, and it has to be allowed to access this provider from other apps. The actual implementation of the content provider depends on you, and you can find a step-by-step guide for building a provider at the Android developer site. However, today I've got some tips for you to help implementing a search result provider. Since the main purpose of the search result provider is, well, providing search results, you don't need to implement methods like insert or update, just the query method. All the necessary constant strings like URIPath and columns, which you might need to implement a provider, are already defined in the Search Manager class. Some results, for example, are result card image, which is used for defining an image, poster, or cover of your media, content type for your media's MIME type, and duration, which includes time information in milliseconds. You can also define what data should be passed back to your app when a user clicks on a search result by setting an intent data column value or a combination of intent data ID and a search suggest intent data attribute in the previous searchable element. Therefore, in the query method, you should gather result data from your data source based on the query string, and then map that data into the cursor by using the predefined column names. The Android TV framework will then take your cursor and look it up using the same column names that you used and display nice looking result cards using data that you provide. And that's it. You can verify this by installing your app to the device, performing a test query on Android TV, and you'll find that the results from your app are included. I also have a special tip for you. If you've had the chance to use Android TV devices, you may have noticed this. As you see here, the search result itself came from Google, but when a user clicks this button, a specific app is launched directly. We call this a watch action link, and with your app, you can take advantage of this cool feature, and it's really easy to do. When you provide data for search results and return enough metadata to identify that the media from your app matches the result from Google, then Android TV will automatically attach the Watch Action link on the search result card. So keep this in mind. Try to provide rich and accurate metadata for your media to assist this process. And here's just one last thing for you. If you would like to provide in-app search functionality in your app, this is really easy as well. Just override the on search requested callback in your TV activity, and the default search icon will appear on the top of your layout, like this. Whenever a user selects the search icon or clicks the search button on the remote control, your callback will be invoked. Inside the callback, you can launch your own search result activity, as shown in this example here. To make your life easier, the Leanback support library provides a search fragment widget, which implements a main layout for the search result screen. And you can find out more detailed information about the Leanback library in this previous DevByte. If you want to test the concepts I just explained, the code is available as a sample at this link here. If you want to learn more about other interesting Android TV features like recommendations, the background manager, you should definitely check out the Android TV documentation at the Android Developers website. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm Wayne Piekarski. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.